Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at different ways that you can use iTunes to create mixtapes. So back when I was growing up, mixtapes were an important part of forming friendships and dating. It was important to share the music that you loved with people you knew. And to do that, you would use cassette tapes and create these mixtapes of your favorite songs or songs that somehow define your relationship with another person. Now that cassette tapes are gone, of course, you have to use digital forms of mixtapes. And iTunes lets you create mixes of music in various different ways. Let's take a look at some ways to do it. So here we are in iTunes, and here's a sample music collection I've got. Now, I have all these songs in my music library, and I want to create a mixtape to share with somebody. First thing I need to do is I need to create a playlist. And a playlist is kind of like a mixtape. So I can do that in several ways. I'll go File and New Playlist and create this playlist. I'll call it Mixtape and put it right there. And it's empty. Now to add songs to it, all I need to do is drag and drop songs from my music library to the mixtape right there. So I'll just pick a few songs here that will serve as a sample mixtape. And there we go. And I click on mixtape and I see I've got four songs by four different artists in there. So the next thing you want to do is you want to set the order for the songs. Now in a playlist they're going to be in the order that you added them. And you can see they're numbered 1 to 4 there. Now I can change the order by dragging and dropping. So I can move this song down one like that. And you can see that the numbers stay 1, 2, 3, 4. I can also sort them by clicking on any of the things here at the top. So I can sort them by name or by artist, date added, things like that. If I click on the top of the first column, it'll put back in the order that I've last arranged them. So starting with the order I added them and then I made a change there. It's probably the order that you want and you can arrange them as you want. This is very important to have them in the right order because as you burn CDs and things, this is the order they're going to be in. Now, what can you do to give this to a friend? Well, one of the things you can do is you can create a CD. So if you have a Mac that has an optical drive, you can insert a blank CD and burn this in one of three different ways. So let's go to File and Burn Playlist to Disk. And this is, I have the playlist selected here, I'm in it, so it knows which playlist I'm talking about. Then I have several options. You can say I have audio CD, MP3 CD, or data CD. Now audio CD is going to burn a standard audio CD. The advantage of this is that it'll work on any CD player, car CD player, portable CD player, home stereo CD player, anything. It's the original CD technology from the 80s. Disadvantage is the length of the CD. For audio, you can't really put that much on it. You can usually store between 74 and 80 minutes of music onto an audio CD. But it's universal, so it's very nice that it could you could do this, and if it's a short mixtape, you can give it to anybody. MP3 CD is going to actually put the files on there as MP3 files, and this is great because you can fit a ton, hundreds of MP3s on a CD. Doing it that way is great, and data will simply burn a data CD that won't actually be playable in most CD players, but if the person is just going to get this and play it on their computer, they'll be able to use it on a Mac or a PC there. So a few things before you decide which one you want to burn is you want to look at the length of your mixtape. At the bottom of the window here, you'll see four songs, how many minutes it is, and what the size is. So if you're burning an audio CD, you want to make sure that's under the size of your audio CD. So if the CDs you bought say 74 minutes on them, you want to make sure this is less than 74 minutes. If you're burning an MP3 or a data CD, you want to make sure that the size here is something that can fit on there as well. Another thing is that if you're burning an MP3 CD, you can only use MP3 files. So these are probably all MP3 files here, but if they're not, you can control click on them and you can see where it says create AAC version. Well, if I go into iTunes preferences and in there I do the import settings right there, and I switch to MP3 encoder and I set the quality amount, then when I control click on a song that is not an MP3 song, it'll say create MP3 version. And you can actually select all of yours and create MP3 version. So before you even get to the playlist stage, or maybe just after you create your playlist, you want to convert them all to MP3 files if you want to actually use an MP3 CD, and you may have to actually recreate your playlist with the MP3 versions you created as opposed to these, which may be AAC or some other format. Now there's some other ways that you could share this. If you go to Store, and you can see that there's a Share Playlist option. So let's go to that, and you can see that it gives you two options here, Gift and Publish. So let's first look at Publish. I click on Publish here and I'm signed into my iTunes account. It's going to put these four songs here in a list and it's going to allow me to name this published list and enter a description for it. And when I'm done with that I can hit Publish. And then I end up with this mixtape here that's a published list on Ping. So what I could do from this point is I can post this playlist on Ping, and in this case I'm not using Ping, but if I was I could post it and there would actually be this published list that other people could access and then decide to buy the entire playlist. So if you're using Apple's free Ping service, then you could try that out. It's not quite a mixtape because you're asking the other person to buy the music, but it's still a great way maybe to share the list with your friends. Perhaps they already own these songs or just want to see what it is that you like to listen to. Now the other option here is to gift the list. So what will happen here is it's going to go and look at the iTunes store. First it's going to make sure that all those songs are available in iTunes. In this case they are. And if not all available it'll tell you. Then you can actually title and put your name, recipient's name, their email address, and a personal message about this. And you're actually going to here buy all of the music and gift a complete playlist, like your own album, to this person. And they'll get an email, or you could actually choose to print it out and they'll get a code that they could use to redeem. You can see right there, I'll do the print gift myself. And using that code, or using the link in the email, they will actually be able to get all of these songs from the iTunes store and they'll be added to their iTunes collection. Now there's the question of legalities. Is it legal to create a mixtape, an audio CD or an MP3 CD and give it to a friend? Well, that's a question for lawyers, and certainly it's the same question that came about with the use of mixtapes in the 80s. Now for purchasing this stuff and giving it as a gift, of course, that makes perfect sense and there's no legal issues there. One other thing I want to show you is you can control click or right click on the playlist there and go to Export. And there you can export the playlist. Now, what happens when you export a playlist? Well, you end up with a text file. Let's put that on the desktop here. And this is what you get. You get basically a tab delimited file that includes all the information about all the tracks in the playlist. So this could come in handy if you want to actually print out a list of the songs and you want to have a quick way to do it instead of typing out the song names. Another way to do it is to select all here and then do edit copy, command C. Then if we go to text edit here and we paste it in, we get a shorter, easier to edit list with the artists and song names. So there's a look at how to create some modern day mixtapes using iTunes. You can also use them to create things for yourself. For instance, an audio CD that contains songs that you can listen to in your car. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.